All right, Bertrand, we're back with another gift guide for runners. And this time we're tackling beginner runners. So here are our top products for beginner runners. Welcome to RaceMob, where we've got training tips, running reviews, and inspirational stories. Check out our podcast, YouTube channel, Instagram account, or visit us at racemob.com. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so that you get notified when new videos go live. So for beginner runners, I think that the main distinction is maybe these are folks who just got into running recently. You know, the pandemic has happened. A lot of people have just gotten into running and they are just starting out. This list is mainly for people that are looking to run probably their first 5K or have just gotten into it. And so our goal today was to find some products that really fill out those essentials that runners need. So, you know, things that maybe they haven't gotten for themselves because they're so brand new into running, and things that really motivate them and keep them going and really build on that momentum that they started off with. So fantastic list. Thank you so much for adding to this list. And let's get right into it. So number one on the list is actually a carryover, something similar from our couch potato list, but we think it's so important that we wanted to list it twice, and that is running shoes. Running shoes. So talk to us about running shoes, why it made our list again.
You gotta. So running in general, it's a very accessible sport where you don't need a court, right? You don't need a gym, you don't need a team, but you do need some good running shoes. And it gives you a great opportunity to go and get professionally fitted by a running professional. Running in the right pair of shoes is just as important in running in shoes in general. So find the right pair of shoes that work for you. Sometimes spending a little bit more will make your running in experience more enjoyable versus having aches and pains just because you may not be in the right type of shoe, depending on your foot strike, pronation, supination. There are all types of different things that can affect your experience while running, and shoes are certainly one of them.
Yeah. And this is a fantastic gift to a beginner runner because basically you can take them with you to a shoe store, get them professionally fitted because maybe they started running and they started running in a pair of old sneakers or something that they had lying around and they never got fitted for the right pairs of shoes. And as we know from talking to shoe store owners and whatnot, they have amazing technology that can help them figure out what types of shoes are perfect for your feet. They help you with the gait analysis and understanding all of that. And 90% to 95% of people that start out running are just in the wrong size of shoe, let alone, you know, the right type of shoe and all of that. So getting them into the right shoe is really going to help them enjoy the sport, run longer in the sport. And even if they've been professionally fitted once, the cool thing as a gift is you can get them another type of shoe. Maybe they have one comfortable pair for longer distance running and they want a speed shoe or a trail shoe. So shoes, again, as a runner, there's very, very few things that you need that are absolute necessities. Shoes, one of them. And so what a fantastic gift if you can give them the gift of shoes and support a local running store in the process. Awesome. So number two that we've got here, we're talking about apparel. We're talking about shirts and shorts particularly, because I think a lot of times when people come in, and they start running, they don't have enough apparel gear. And when you look good and you feel good, you're going to want to do it more. I mean, it's as simple as that, right? And so, so we think shirts, shorts, these are really great things to get people, especially because we know a lot of people who started running in cotton shirts. And again, when we asked our group, our community, what are the essential tips for beginner runners, one of the main things was getting people into the right gear because, you know, all sorts of chafing can happen. All sorts of other stuff can happen if you're not in the right gear. So Running Warehouse is one of those places that they've got a lot of great gear for runners. They've got a lot of great guides for runners. But it's as simple as just getting them a lot of cheaper, I would say, gear when you're beginning. Because, you know, you're not going to need super fanciful, super high-tech gear. You just need a lot of them. And you know, for potentially a lot of our beginner runners, you're going to be starting to lose weight. Your body's going to be changing a little bit. So you're not going to need, you're going to want just some new gear that fits you well as you go along. So, yeah, we think that is pretty good gift here.
And the very good points, KC. And you want gear that sheds water, that is not moisture wicking, that doesn't have that, like a cotton garment is going to hold water and actually feel heavier as well. So these moisture wicking garments that are, you know, polyester blends, lightweight and breathable will again help your running experience.
Fantastic. And while we're on the subject, I mean, no better gear than what we've got right here. So if you want to support a local running club, and who's this handsome fella right here? Too Legit has fantastic gear here. All of this working with partners, moisture wicking, fantastic stuff for you to wear out on the trails. And they've got great tees and, you know, great winter gear as well. If you want some winter gear, we know it's getting a little bit colder, as well as great tanks and, you know, people in warmer climates. You know, we're here in California. It's nice and sunny today. Tanks aren't a bad thing through the wintertime either. So great gear up here on Too Legit if you want to help support a local running club. Otherwise, if you're looking for just gear, Running Warehouse has some great stuff. Even Amazon has some great stuff for the beginner runner. So really recommend that. Next on our list, something to keep the sun out of your eyes. So whether that's visors or whether that's hats, we really recommend head sweats. They have been geared towards runners. So athletic style visors that have that elastic strap. So it's not chafing. It's not really bouncing around and moving around a lot. They've got some great stuff. I mean, look at this Christmas stuff. So, you know, if you have it in time for Christmas, if you want to get them some fantastic Christmas stuff. They've got some really cool hats as well. You know, I'm from Colorado, so every time I see something Colorado, I love it. But they also have some great California stuff. I was looking, you know, down this list. They've got some great Golden Gate Bridge stuff down here. So fantastic stuff from Head Sweats and partner of both RaceMob and Too Legit. We know we're coming in with some RaceMob visors and hats coming in the next couple of weeks. And we've already got some Too Legit visors and hats here. So again, they've been a partner. Head Sweats is a partner. And so they provide some fantastic gear and it's built for runners.
Yeah, Will said those running caps you showed on the head sweats and the visors, they have in many cases a built-in sweatband. So as much as they're breathable and they feel good, but they also keep that sweat from running down in your eyes as well. So
yeah, and you know, we love our headbands over here because they keep the sweat out of your eyes over here. The visors do the same thing. They keep the sweat out of your eyes and the sun out of your eyes. So really great item that not a lot of, you know, beginner runners start off with. Not a lot of us have visors like lying around, especially running visors. So this is a great essential gift for runners to keep them running longer. Okay, next thing on the list, in the times that we're living in during the pandemic, these are great items, buffs as well as face masks, and getting some stylish buffs, some stylish face masks to go along with your running. Here, you know, we're just about to enter shelter in place again over here, and wearing the masks is becoming essential, especially in many cities. So do your part, wear your mask, and just like you showed, we've got some Too Legit masks too. So fantastic stuff. So fantastic Too Legit, double-sided masks as well. You know, and great buffs. The buffs are fantastic too because they can keep you warm in the wintertime. So even if you are running alone, I see a lot of times like Seth DeMore on his channel, he's running up in the mountains. It is freezing cold. He's got to wear something to cover his face and keep it, you know, nice and warm. So a lot of these things, you know, there are fleece buffs, there are other buffs. And of course, you know, when you're running with these things, of course, your breathing changes a little bit. It's not like you can breathe the same, but that just means, you know, slow down a little bit. Make sure that you are just making the most out of your breath. And actually what it does is it helps you become more efficient at utilizing oxygen and all the rest of the stuff. So I know it sucks to watch your average time go down, your numbers go down. You're like, what the heck? I wish I could be running faster. But in the long run, there are actually physiological benefits to running, you know, with masks on, with things like you just got to run a little bit slower and build up that tolerance over time.
Yep. Well said, awesome. Casey.
Awesome. Okay. So next on our list for beginners, we're talking about safety here a little bit. And especially during the winter time, you know, you might be running and it might be dark. It might be dark early in the morning. It might be dark later at night. We know how it is. I mean, we're working right towards that winter solstice this year. So, I mean, you know, right towards it. Christmas is right after the winter solstice. So literally the days are as tiny as they can get. And so for a beginner runner, you know, encouraging them to try lights, be safe out there when they're running at nighttime. And so we've got a couple of lights here, all within, you know, reason. I think $20, $30 around here. You know, these are like shoe lights that you place onto your shoelaces, and they blink. We know that there's a couple of these also that are on the Too Legit site that are recommended here. So talk to us about lights. I know some people wear headlamps as well, especially trail racers. I don't know. I always feel like they're bouncing around a little bit too much. Right. And the waist lamps work a little bit better for some folks, but yeah. I mean, you probably have a couple of lights. I don't think I have too many lights. Yeah, I use my phone sometimes, but
the waist lights are great. Sometimes a handheld as well, but if you like to run hands free and not have the bounciness of a headlamp, the waist lamps are fantastic. And Ultra Aspire, who's one of our partners, they do great work. I think they're based in Utah. They have specials going on now around the holidays. Really good stuff. Very durable. And they have entry-level units all the way up to a bit more expensive, but the durability and the lumens range is fantastic.
Yeah. So we think for a beginner runner, if you're just running around your house, you're not doing too much trail running or going out, you know, deep into the woods and stuff, you can probably stick to something that's beginner level, entry level. Just get them encouraged to go out there, you know, any time of the day. The worst thing that you can give a beginner runner is an excuse. Don't want to give them an excuse. So, you know, make sure that they feel safe out there, and then encourage them to get out. Okay. Next thing on our list is a RaceMob coaching program. And we think this is, again, perfect for the beginner runners, especially because Coach B will do some form analysis for you. So when we're talking about running for beginners, form, running form is so important because it helps you with efficiency. It helps reduce your injury, your likelihood to become injured. And, you know, we do all sorts of taking a look at it, breaking it down, working with you to help you see where your form could improve, be more efficient over time. And so really the coaching program we think is a great, great present, a great gift for the beginner runner. Not only do we give you this form analysis, but we do help you plan out your workouts. We help you. So, you know, you could buy a workout journal and all of that, or you could just come to Coach B and he will help you plan out your workouts for the next several months and make sure that you're seeing progress and you're getting towards your goals. So, fantastic gift for yourself. You know, we've seen a lot of success with our runners, new PRs, by almost all of them, and they're having fun. They're enjoying it. And I think that's the big thing is when you're getting into running, having that camaraderie, having that accountability, having friends to cheer you on along the way, those are the things that you really, really enjoy.
Yes.
And again, we're running a special right now. Yeah. Yeah. And being able to talk to people when you have questions, when you aren't sure what to do, you know, having a coach in your corner that is there to help you out and wants to see success as badly as you do, it's motivational. It'll get you up and out of bed. So we're running a special right now, 6 months. 6 months for $99.95. We hope you sign up. We'll have a link down here. Come sign up. You'll get a one-on-one coaching session with Coach B, and you know, we'll start the program whenever you want to start. So if you're buying this as a Christmas present, we can start the program on January 1st. You can have your consultation with Coach B in the beginning of the new year. But you know, we're really here to be on your side to help you out, help you plan and train to hit your goals. Next item on the list, water bottles, hydration.
Yeah, you got it. especially in the beginning. Well, hydration is important wherever you are in your fitness and running journey. And being able to carry your hydration with you where it's comfortable, where it's not sloshing. So if you have a hydration backpack, hydration vest, a waist belt, or handheld, this company, again, Ultra Spa, they do fantastic work. You can also find similar handhelds via Amazon, Target, but being able to take your hydration with you in a way that works best for you. If you're getting comfortable in carrying in hand, within a backpack, or on your waist, find what works best for you. And you don't have to spend a ton of money, but it is important to stay hydrated, even if that means, you know, taking a water bottle with you. But as you tend to stretch out those distances, you want to carry more ounces so you can make sure you're properly hydrated through the duration of your workout.
Yeah, can't echo this enough. And especially with beginner runners, most of our training programs tend to be time-based. So, you know, you are running slower. You're going to be out there on your feet for a good amount of time, you know, 45 minutes to an hour of walking / jogging and those types of things. And you are going to want water. In a lot of those cases, you are going to want hydration, some sort of fluid. You know, I think another brand that's really popular out there is the Nathan brand. Oh, yeah. I have a couple of Nathan water bottles or waste packs. They've got one that's a handheld that you can bring your credit card or your phone and kind of, you know, hang on to that, which is an insulated bottle, which is great for, you know, both the wintertime and the summertime. So really just a great product for the beginner, because a lot of the times when you start running, it's not something that you have bought. You don't own one of these things, but these get so much use, you know. And I think for distances between like a 5K and maybe like 10K half marathon, depending on where you are, you can probably get away with this amount of water. You know, obviously when you're going to marathon distance or like 15, 18 miles, you're doing something self-supported, you're going to want more water. Backpack, something else. But for the beginner runner, this is going to last you. Like this type of water bottle is going to last you for the vast, vast majority of your runs.
Very practical as well. That is a very practical and good investment.
Next on our list, these flip belts, waist carriers. I know I've mentioned this before I've mentioned this type of product before when we're doing the Prime Day deals, but runners, we don't like to carry stuff. And, you know, if you can avoid carrying things in your hand, your phone and your other stuff in your hand, that's all the better, right? Flip belts have a pretty good reputation of being a product that also doesn't allow for a lot of bouncing. So things hold tightly to the skin, to the, you know, back, to the everything. They hold tightly in there. And so there's not a lot of bouncing as you run, which just helps in general. That's what you're looking for. And you can carry quite a bit of gear in here. So your phone, you know, some of these flip belts have spot for hydration. So if they really do want to run hands-free, that's an option there too. Keys, other stuff, you know,
gels.
Yeah, absolutely. So, so I know that this is highly recommended and they'll last you almost forever.
They will. I'm glad you should, because I have two of these probably in my fitness toolkit buried somewhere. And again, they're very practical. So I'll have to, pull one of them out and use it on my next, run in the coming days.
There you go. Yeah, especially if you're running with those run pods, then you're going to want to be hands-free, you know. You're going to want to carry some gear on you.
Yeah.
All right, so another gift that we have on here is running watches. We know that in the last segment we did for the couch potato, we just talked about activity trackers and things that would, you know, measure steps and whatnot. But if they're starting to run and they're really starting to get into it, we do recommend a GPS watch, something that is satellite positioning, you know, cognizant, right? So so that you can actually measure the distance of that run. You can map it out in advance. You can take a look at it. Garmin, we think, does a bang up job, fantastic job. Yeah. And on the back end, it's like an open source API. So when we use our tool, Final Surge, for coaching athletes, we can really dive into the analytics of that run, the elevation of the run, the time splits. A lot of these have heart rate trackers, even if it's wrist held heart rate tracker, some of them connect to, you know, the chest heart rate trackers. We can really dive into the analytics of the run to help you get better from run to run when you buy a GPS related watch. The other real benefit to GPS watches is, you know, we oftentimes give our runners goals, targeted paces, you know, targeted time, if there's going to be 2 minutes on, 1 minute off, those types of things. By having the wristwatch, you can look down quickly and you can say, oh, how is my pace tracking? Am I within the threshold, within the target? Am I running to what the coach wants me to be running? And we can look at that afterwards and analyze, again, heart rate. We can analyze, hey, were we really targeting the VO2 max thresholds? Were we targeting anaerobic thresholds? Were we easing back? That's the other thing, right? Were you actually running at easy pace, at comfortable conversational pace? And we can take a look at all of that. But again, this is, and they're not super expensive anymore. I mean, I remember these things, the very first GPS watch that I bought was like $400 and something, and it can't do half the things that these watches these days can. So
that is that's a great value with that unit. I have that unit right here. Serves me very well. And Kevin, you hit the nail right on the head in regards to all the analytics and how it feeds into our athlete training calendar program, Final Surge. And that's a great value. It's a great entry-level watch that is very scalable, even as you progress in your running journey up to running half marathons and beyond. Great suggestion.
Yeah. And I think, you know, obviously for the intermediate advanced runner, if you're looking to be more hardcore, you know, you have fallen in love with this, you're going for marathons, you're going for other things, there are other watches that we would recommend for those folks that are more full featured, you know, allow you to play music right off of them and other stuff. Maybe you don't like carrying your phone. Some of these have, you know, phones in them, all of that stuff. But for the entry level, for the beginner runner, getting a GPS watch will help immensely. And it'll help because then you can see progress over time and track all of that. So fantastic gift for the entry-level runner. Obviously, there are other watches that are similar in the similar price range, maybe that even look a little bit better and whatnot. So a lot of watches, what you're looking for, though, is GPS watch. You are looking for a GPS watch. And we do recommend Garmin. I think Suunto's pretty good. Polar's pretty good. They all kind of connect into Final Surge as well. Garmin just kind of has, even though they had this like shutdown in the middle of the year last year, but they have a good reputation of being there for runners. So, you know, but you're looking for basically GPS watch, entry level GPS watch is something that you might be looking for. All right. Okay. And then we're getting to some of the final things on our list. Socks. You wouldn't believe how how important socks are for running. It's kind of crazy. But, you know, again, when we asked our community for stories for beginner runners, for advice for beginner runners, socks was like way up the list. I think it ended up at number 5 on the list, so, along with, you know, like run slower, run with motivate, you know, other stuff. But socks was on the list because I think a lot of runners have run into blisters and other things that cotton socks can give. And most of the times you don't have running socks when you start running, right? It's just not something that you have. So one thing to think about giving a runner is maybe something funny, you know, like they wouldn't buy for themselves. Like I hear a lot of good things about these Injinji socks. I have not tried them. They kind of make me cringe a little bit, like looking at them, like, oh, even though I've run in those, you know, those Vibram five fingers. Yeah. I've run in those before. So like, I know how they're supposed to, you know, but sometimes it's fun to just give runners like things that they'd never buy for themselves, never think about on their own, you know, something fun and unique and interesting. So these Injinji socks,
love socks. Yep.
That's the other thing too, is I was listening to a podcast recently and they said, you know, what's something small that has drastically improved your life? And somebody mentioned these like $15 socks that they're wearing. And they were running socks. And he said, okay, once I bought them, every time I put them on, I would want to go on a run because, you know, it was just like a reminder. Right. And so, yeah, socks can be a splurge. They can be a bit of a splurge. You can spend quite a bit of, you know, these are $16 socks right here, right? $16, $15 socks. But that's the fun thing about gifting is sometimes you can gift a little bit of splurge that the person would not have thought about on their own. You know, and they can be things that, hey, every time they put them on, they want to do something and they want to get out and they're reminded of the person that gifted them that item. You know, so, Balega has really, really great socks for runners.
Like a comforter on your feet. Someone said one time, man, those, the Balega socks are like John Legend singing to your feet. It was the weirdest comment. I'm like, okay, they are comfortable. They are they are super comfortable. A little bit thicker, but super, super comfortable. And they do have thinner versions as well. But typically, the comfort comes from the fabric. Great value.
Yeah, yeah. And as we get into the intermediate advanced runners, we may be talking about compression socks. We may be talking about, right, like other things that are great for longer distance and more things. But these types of socks for beginner runners are fantastic. They just will make your feet feel better and will make you want to go out on a run. So fantastic item there. Last couple of things on our list are around recovery. One of them is around plantar fasciitis. So some foot compression sleeves, some injury compression sleeves, and to relieve joint pain. And then this is another item on the list. Last time we talked about the normal, regular foam roller, right? The $20 foam roller. Those foam rollers, they get better, more expensive. if they're looking to get into running, these foam rollers are great for any sport, regardless, of what sport, but we're talking about recovery. We're talking about feeling better. We're talking about instilling good habits early on that will make you want to run, more and more over time, right? We're talking about injury prevention habits and all of that. And so getting a great foam roller, something splurgy, something that they wouldn't spend on themselves, these ones are vibrating foam rollers. And again, when we get to intermediate advanced, we'll talk about percussion guns and other stuff. But getting a nice foam roller that you wouldn't buy for yourself, I think that's a fantastic and fun present as well. Okay. Last thing on our list, photo frames. We had talked a little bit. Yeah, Coach, this was on your list. This is something that you had talked about. And I think this is a great idea, especially if they have like a race in mind or something that they want to get to or a goal in mind, a 13.1 or 26.2. We talked to all your athletes. We know that you are the master of the sneaky, persuasive, the little push. So
visualization. You know, the ability, if you like you're where you're headed, Casey, is if there's something you're training for or something you want to do, put yourself there. Imagine yourself crossing that finish line for your very first half marathon or your very first marathon, or maybe you're getting a family member into their very first 10K. And how is that finishing photo going to look? Or when you're there with your loved ones, and to be able to save that moment as a keepsake, these photo frames here are fantastic for those special moments. Yes, the photo can reside on your smartphone, but it's different when it's there in the home, in the office, sent to grandma, grandpa, or to mom, or with your child. So these are great ways to pay it forward and preserve those special moments of somebody's first. I love these.
Fantastic. All right. Well, that is our list for beginner runners, our gift guide for beginner runners. If you like this list, give us a thumbs up. If you like more running news and tips, hit subscribe button. We've also got a link to our other gift guides down here. If we missed something, something that you loved when you were a beginner runner, or something that made you change your attitude towards running, got you to love it a little bit more, comment down below. Let us know. Let us know if it's something that you love, and you know, we'll add it to our gift guide. This can be a living gift guide as we continue to go and continue to grow. So thank you again so much, B, and thank you guys again for watching, and we will see you again real soon.